of our language also easily call up ideas which are taken from the life of the present. By way of the awakened soul life of the woman, the readers first develop the soul life of the men. In the colony we have described, the influence of the women was therefore very great. One had to go to them for advice when one wanted to interpret the signs of nature. The whole manner of their soul life, however, was still dominated by masculine human soul forces. One does not describe the matter quite exactly, but fairly closely, if one speaks of a somnambulistic contemplating harmony of women. In certain higher dreams, the secrets of nature were divulged to them, and they received new impulses for their action. Everything was animated to them and showed itself to them in full powers and apparitions. They abandoned themselves to the mysterious weaving of their soul forces. That which impelled them to their actions were inner voices, or like plants, animals, stones, wind and clouds, the whispering of the trees, and so on, told them. From this state of soul originated what was once and all human religion. The spiritual in nature and in human life gradually changed and regenerated in worship. Some women attained a special preeminence because out of special mysterious depths they could interpret what the world contained. Thus it would come to pass among such women that which lived within them would transpose itself into a kind of natural language. For the beginning of language lies in something that is similar to song. The energy of thought was transformed into audible sound. The inner rhythm of nature sounded from the lips of wise women. One gathered around such women and in their song-like sentences felt governed to the higher power. Human worship of the gods began with such things. For that period there can be no question. Then, in that which was spoken, sound, tone, and rhythm were perceived. One did not imagine anything along the scene, but absorbed in the flow the power of what was heard. The whole process was under the direction of the higher leader. They had inspired the wise priestesses with tones and rhythms in a manner which cannot now be further discussed. Thus they could have an ennobling effect on the souls of men. One can say that in this way the true life is the soul first awakened. In this realm, beautiful scenes are shown by the Apostle Chronicles. One scene will be described. We are in a forest, near a mighty tree. The sun has just risen in the east. The palm-like trees, from around which the other trees have been removed, cast mighty shadows. The priestess, her face turned to me, ecstatic, sits on a seat made of rare natural objects and plants. Slowly in rhythmical sequence, a few strange, constantly repeated sounds stream from her lips. A number of men and women are sitting in circles around her, their faces lost in dreams, absorbing inner life from what they hear. Other scenes too can be seen. At a similarly arranged place of priestess, sings in a similar manner, but her tones have in them something mightier, more powerful. Those around her move in rhythmic dances, for this was the other way in which souls entered into mankind. The mysterious rhythm which one had heard from nature was imitated by the movements of the land. One thereby felt at one with nature and with the powers acting in her. The place on earth in which this stock of a coming race of men was developed was especially suited for this purpose. It was one where the then still turbulent earth had become fairly calm.